don't push, don't fight, don't flee. I still say that. Why? Because that don't work. And you might say, well, like you are saying, I think, well, if you don't do those three things, what are you going to do? You do what you're told. You don't make any move at all. And you still might get shot.
He did.
Why? Because, yes, because that's the white supremacist doctrine. They're sending black people a message over and over again. You don't have any business breathing if I decide that you're going to stop breathing. When are you thick-skulled people are going to learn that? I have absolute power over you. You will die when I say you die, and you will breathe when I say that you breathe. And I am going to reinforce that whenever I see fit. Now, what do you do about that?
Yes.
You look at it just like what it is. This is why it's real important to get rid of racism and stop all these other priorities that we say that we have. Man, I ain't got time to talk about no racism. I got to go here. I got to go there. I got all these other things to do. You're up here talking all this nonsense about some racism. Racism is here. So what? I mean, I got things to do. Well, you're not going to do nothing because the racism is going to stop you from doing whatever you're doing if it's something that makes sense. Because that's what the racism is really all about. It's not anything you can step around. You're going to be subject to it because we're all on a battlefield. And I have said that when you see anybody who is acting in behalf of racism approach you with the means of sudden death, you practically have to consider yourself dead. This is the way to look at it. You can't look at it any other way. I mean, your heart should be in your mouth just by a person standing there talking to you who is able to cause sudden death. Just talking to you, you should say, hey, I might be dead at any minute. I can't play with this at all. And even then, not playing with it, doing everything that you're supposed to do, just like anybody on a battlefield. On a battlefield, if you've seen movies of battlefields, sometimes that soldier who has that gun pointed at you just decides, well, I thought that I was going to take you prisoner, but now that I have a second thought about it, ain't nobody out here but me and you. And I was going to take you prisoner, but I don't have time to be bothered with prisoners. So he takes that rifle and does what? Shoots you right there in the head. It happens on battlefields all the time. And the person has an option of taking you prisoner or killing you. And you're there with your hands up. You have already surrendered. You're standing there with nothing. And you say, hey, you know, I'm now your prisoner. I agree with that. I'm not fussing. I'm not arguing. Take me to your prison camp. Because that's where we really all are. And the soldier standing there, the race soldier, that's what the textbook calls him, says, you know what? I'm not taking you nowhere. I'm going to kill you. And so you just did. And I say, from what I could see, it looks like it was just a decision was made. That's what it looks like to me.
Yes.
I wasn't on the jury, so I might not be privy to all the information. But it looks like to me a decision was made. I'm not going to tolerate, you know, I'm not going to even be bothered with this. I'm not bothered, you know, I don't even want to give this guy a ticket.
Okay.
I'm going to kill him. Bang, 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 bang. You're dead. And apparently, if the white supremacists had anything to do with it, they say, yeah, this worked the way it should work. Well, this is what every black person should expect. Get rid of those balloons and whatnot on the fences and whatnot. Don't do any more of that. Because this is going to continue. You have to get rid of the entire system of racism in order for that to stop. That's the prescription. Otherwise, just keep moaning and groaning about being killed for nothing. Because you're going to be killed for nothing. You've got to get that in your minds. You have to have that in your mind.